question is, are you for full practice authority for nurse practitioners in Arkansas?
Well, thank you. I've sponsored that twice, and you know, it's been very heavy lift to do that because doctors show up in masks, in their white coats, and the fact is the medical society and the hospital association are the most, two of the most powerful lobbies in the state of Arkansas, bar none. And when you go up against that lobby, you risk not getting donations for your campaign from the medical society and the hospitals, which is a lot of money for a lot of people. You also risk not being on committees and not being in, being seen as somebody who will toe the line and do what you're supposed to do. I fit in that category, but I've stood for that because it's the right thing to do for Arkansas, and it will drive down the cost considerably. But to me, the issue is not just whether we allow licensed people to practice to the full scope of their training and ability. As I mentioned, in Arkansas State, we're well-trained, well-qualified, highly successful people and professional people, and we're going to let them come out and we're going to cap them and say, you can't do that. How many other degrees at Arkansas State are you willing to do that to? How many would you be willing to limit what those people can do? It's only the rare group where we put that cap on expertise and professionalism. To me, it's also about my ability to choose to go to you. If I choose to go to you, who is the medical society or the medical board to tell me I can't? That's between you and I. And I stand for personal freedom. Again, just another example. I get to carry around a loaded weapon, but I can't choose to go see an APN. It just doesn't sound right. Thank you.
So when it comes to nurse practitioners, I've been an advocate for nurse practitioners for several years. My clinics, the ER, we use nurse practitioners. I have no issue with nurse practitioners. I mean, I respect them as individuals, and you know, I value the work that they do. But when a nurse practitioner graduates, they have about 2,000 to 3,000 clinical hours before they see their first patient. Physician, when they graduate from residency, has between 16,000 to 20,000 hours. And to be honest, neither one of those is probably enough to feel fully comfortable taking care of a patient. So like I was talking about with the telemedicine issue earlier, you know, there's, you gotta put the patient first about safety, okay? So you have a newly minted nurse practitioner, you put her out in a very rural area all by herself, and what you're asking is to take the safety net of a collaborative physician away from that person. And I just have a concern about that. Now, for the nurse practitioner that's been out there for 10 years, you know, that's a different story. It's a totally different story. And I think when it comes to healthcare, the team approach is best. And the team being all the way from receptionist to the nurse, to the doctor, to the nurse practitioner. It should be a team approach, all working together to deliver the best care possible. And so, yeah, I support nurse practitioners. And as far as freedom to choose, you can see a nurse practitioner in the next 5 minutes if you want to. One, you actually go to my clinic, you can see it. So you have the right to choose, and it's already there.